Alright, what is up guys? Welcome to my channel. Jimmy here, Jimmy K Travel. So, I'm going to tell you a little bit about my exploration in Sangklaburi. And, you know, I love Sangklaburi, I love Thailand, I love travel. And my first Sangklaburi experience was in 2013, which you're going to see in these videos. And along the way, all the way to 2017. So you'll be wondering, what is Sangklaburi? It's actually a very small town. Very close to the Burmese border. It's actually the two ethnic tribes. You have the Karen and the Hmong. And the famous thing in Sangklaburi, if you want to visit, is actually the Hmong Bridge. It's the longest bridge in Thailand. And I think in recent 2 years, 3 years ago, the bridge was broken down and then they built another bridge. But I want to show you my experiences. The first try I did was an elephant ride, which I really love going there. So the first session you see is in 2013. We went to Sangklaburi and it was raining then. I think it went in June, and around June that time, June-ish. So if you go around June and September, it's rainy season in Thailand, so you're gonna get yourself wet and get yourself prepared. Yeah, and this is the boat ride. We are about to head out to the elephant. So basically, we actually hire a charter boat to actually go to another location, a resort. And then from there, we're gonna wear our poncho because it's raining. Then we're gonna take another boat to go to a jeep, where we're gonna bring us to the camp, the elephant camp, where we can take the elephant ride. I'm gonna leave the link if you wanna know about the place that I actually book, the place that I actually stay in. Anyway, the place I actually stay is P Guest House, and the whole package on this elephant ride is about, I paid about 1,500 baht, and that is include lunch, because we'll be heading back, you know, about middle of the afternoon, about 2-3. Yeah, so it's well worth it. And the place that I stay, it's about 900 baht. Beautiful view. Later on, you can see the view that I took facing the reservoir. And it's well worth it, definitely. Open night, that is. And this is the one that we are heading to the elephant ride. Really excited. And we met a bunch of tourists. These are these tourists from Finland and some from America. So we get to know them. Great people there. But I think that's the fun part about this, the adventure. It's raining adventure, and yeah, so we can see we're getting into the van. I'm so excited that time, heading ready to go, and look at this couple here. Yeah, so it was really fun trip. I would do it again, but this time I'm gonna bring a better camera, of course. I'm gonna get my GoPro. That time I did not have a GoPro. I had my D90. As I said, the resolution wasn't that good, so, but you know, I just had to put it in YouTube and just show you guys. So I can see the elephant guy is coming ready. It was really fun. It was really good. I really enjoyed this. So in here you can see we're getting ready. I didn't feel myself, but it's pretty much the same. We're just getting ready to be hop on to the elephant. Yeah, I was just taking some photos before we actually go into the elephant. So
Korea.
It was a well-deserved trip. Really cool, really cool. Really nice. And the rest of the clip you're gonna see here is probably you're gonna see us riding with the elephant. And the best part I like about this is you see elephant praying through the water, and people are so excited taking photos. I didn't manage to take photos of myself. I think I might have, but I kind of lost some of the footage that I have, unfortunately. This was really an old clip. This was in 2013. I did take some clip of elephant feeding along the way. And it was really fun. And see the view, man, I'm telling you, the view is fantastic. You have come here for the view, not just for the ride, but the view as well, the experience, the adventure. There's feeding, the elephants feeding the vegetation along the way. Highly recommended, guys. If you come to Sangklaburi, you gotta do this tour. And it's not expensive compared to where you are coming from. And here we are threading through the water. This is my favorite part. This is the excitement, this is the fun part. And yeah, I'm gonna do some selfie next time, man. Can go pretty deep in the water. These elephants are pretty much used to going around these routes. Again, the view, the river, man, that is beautiful. Fantastic, I'm loving it. I don't know how many times I have to say it, but I gotta do this again. Gotta do this again. And would you look at that? Threading through the water. We have so much fun. These are people from Finland. A lot of fun right here. Alright, guys, so in 2015, because 2014 I went to Thailand, I went to Sangklaburi again. But unfortunately, I was having diarrhea, so I couldn't film anything. But in 2015, I went there. This time I got my drone. And what you see here is actually the temple, an old temple, a sunken temple. In the rainy season, you can see it actually carved to the roof of the temple. It's really amazing. I don't know what I have footage on that one, but anyway, this is the monk girl. And there you go, this is we did a rafting. You can hire a canoe, we can hire someone to canoe for you, but I'd rather do my own, it's more adventurous. It's about 900 baht ish, I think it's about 900 baht, I can't remember. And this is the bridge I'm talking about, the Hmong and the Korean, the Thai, they usually use this bridge to go across to the mostly the Thai side, I think, or the Thai would go to the Hmong side. I think they're just, you know, trading between these villages. And as I said before, this is the drone shots of the Hmong bridge. See how long it is? And the one that you see on the side, the river, that is the bridge that was collapsed. I think it was 2 years ago, 2014, 13, can't remember. 2014, I remember, I think so. So they had to make another bridge for them to cross over. But I think this was the completed one. correct me if I'm wrong, I can't remember which year. And there you go, you can see people actually going there to explore the temple. This is what it looks like in the temple, and people still use this temple for worshipping, you know. And there's a statue of Buddha there, and you can see a lot of boats coming in, but I prefer to use canoe. So if you want a canoe from where I am to the P guest house, it's going to take 2 hours. So if you have time and you have the energy, then it's well worth it. But if you don't have the time and you don't have the energy, so I suggest you to hire a boat. I think about 300 baht for both ways. It can bring you pretty far. But I want to be adventurous, so every time when I go there, I usually hire a canoe. Okay, so that is, later you're gonna see more of the bridge. This is the bridge. This is not the bridge that's connecting to the village. You can see from the Hmong to the Karen or the Thai. This is just the bridge that they use to connect to the village within the Sangklaburi itself. And it also pretty long, pretty, you know, but the view, man. Gotta love the view. And one thing I love about Sangklaburi is unique. It's uniqueness. You can see the floating restaurant. You can see the floating village, which makes it very different than other places in Thailand, which I've been to. So this is my favorite place, my top pick place to visit in Thailand. And you can see, that's what I'm talking about. Look at that view right there. Look at that view, guys. How can you not love this view? This is the guest house that I'm staying in. P guest house facing the reservoir. Show you the view one last time of the bridge. You can see people using it to commute, you know, from villages to villages. The whole town of Sangklaburi during sunset. So guys, alright, if you made it this far, I said thank you so much for watching. Excite you to visit another town in Thailand, and yeah, I'm gonna leave you with this message. If you like this content, please give me a like and subscribe and leave me a comment below. I would like to hear from you, engage from you, and tell me what kind of place that you visit in Thailand, and where else would you recommend to others that you want to visit. Okay, I see you guys in the next videos.